Hello all, welcome to this course on computer organization. The topics we'll be seeing today are the multi-cycle data path for load and store instruction. So let's begin. So before we get into the designing of a multi-cycle data path, I would request you to go through my previous video on multi-cycle processor and the points you should remember before you begin the designing of a multi-cycle processor. So, as a convention, we always do this for designing, even in the single-cycle processor. The already studied hardware will be given in gray color. The black lines will show the new connections, and the blue lines will stand for the new control signals. The first step will be here to fetch the instruction from instruction memory. And since this is for a load, we'll see that the value will be taken from PC. And this PC will be connected to the address pin A of the instruction memory. And the instruction is read and stored in a new non-architectural instruction register, so that it is available for the future cycles. This instruction register that will receive an enable signal called IR write that is asserted when it should be updated with a new instruction. So let's see the data path connections for the load instruction, and then we'll enhance it to handle other instructions. So for a load instruction, the next step will be to read the source operand that is containing the base address. And this register is specified in the RS field of the instruction, that is bits 21 to 25. These bits are connected to one of the address pins A1 of the register file. And the register file reads the register onto RD1. And this value is stored in another non-architectural register A. Load also requires an offset. You can know that from the format here, from this field. And this offset will be stored in the immediate field of the instruction, that is bits 0 to 15. And it must be sign extended to 32 bits. So this 32-bit sign extended value is called sign im. To be consistent, we might store this in another non-architectural register. But since you can see here, this is a combinational function of the instruction, and it will not change while the current instruction is being processed. So there is no need to dedicate a register to hold this constant value. Address of the load is calculated as the sum of the base address and the offset. We use an ALU here to compute the sum. You can see the ALU control value will be 010 to perform an addition. ALU result is stored in a non-architectural register here called ALU out. The next step will be to load the data from the calculated address in memory. For this, we add a multiplexer in front of the memory to choose the memory address ADR, either from the PC or the ALU out as shown in the figure. The multiplexer select line is called I or D, which indicates either an instruction or a data address. Data read from the memory is stored in another non-architectural register called data. Notice that the address multiplexer permits us to reuse the memory during load instruction. On the first step, address was taken from PC to fetch the instruction. On a later step, address is taken from ALU out to load the data. So hence, I or D must have different values during different steps. Finally, we write back the data to the register file. So the destination register is specified in the RT field bits 16 to 20. While all this is happening, the processor must update the value of PC by adding 4 to the old PC. So, in a single cycle processor, a separate adder was needed here. In a multi-cycle processor, we use the existing ALU on one of the steps when it's not busy. To do so, we insert a source multiplexer to choose PC and constant 4 as ALU inputs. A two-input multiplexer controlled by ALU SRCA chooses either PC or the register A as SRCA. A 4-input multiplexer controlled by ALU SRCB chooses either 4 or the sign immediate as the source B. We use the other two inputs in the multiplexer later when we extend the data path to handle other instructions. Also note that the numbering of inputs to the multiplexer is arbitrary. To update PC, ALU adds SRCA, that is PC, and SRCB, that is 4, and the result is returned to the program counter register. PC write control signal enables the program counter register to be written only on certain cycles. So, this will complete the data path for a load instruction. Now, let us extend this to handle store instruction. Like load instruction, store instruction reads a base address from port 1 of the register file and sign extends the immediate value. And the ALU then adds this base address and the immediate to find the memory address. All of these functions are already supported by the existing hardware in the data path. The only new feature of store is that we must read a second register from the register file and write it to memory. The register is specified in the RT field of the instruction bits, bit 16 to 20, which is connected to the second port of the register file. When the register is read, it is stored into a non-architectural register B. On the next step, it is sent to the write data port of the data memory to be written. And the memory receives a mem write control signal to indicate that the write should occur. So, that's all on how we derive a multi-cycle data path for load and a store instruction. Thank you. Thank you for listening.